It's a tale.
We enjoyed an all top 16 lineup a couple of weeks ago in London, though, for the Ladbrokes World Grand Prix.
Frame, Barry Hawkins to break.
And now it's an all top 16 lineup in the semi-finals of the Ladbrokes Players Championship here in Manchester. Barry Hawkins breaks off. It's a race to six, the best of 11. And just to underline the quality on display here today, Ricky Walden now coming to the table is the lowest ranked player left in the tournament, and he's the world number 11. Super crowd, tremendous venue. Everything set fair for what should be a cracking Saturday of snooker. And talking of quality, Neil Falls has joined me in the commentary box.
You're too kind, Phil. Tough one this, isn't it? Who's going to win? Very equal standing in the game, I feel. I suppose Barry has got the slight edge in that he's played in a world final and two other world semi-finals. But, you know, I suppose Ricky Walden, because he's won all of his ranking events in Asia, maybe he's not so known in this country. It's unusual for someone born and bred over here. Earlier in the week, Barry Hawkins, when he was eyeing up this tournament, he said he was hoping to get to Saturday and beyond, where the matches increase from best of sevens to an 11 today, best of, and then, of course, the final best of 19. And we know that he likes the longer matches, settles into them nicely. Having said that, of course, he won his last ranking event when this tournament was best of seven up to the final and including the final.
Yes, a best of seven for £100,000, that's pressure, but he handled it really well, beat Gerard Green, a good friend of his, 4-0 to capture the title at Preston Guildhall a couple of years ago. Hawkins and Sean Murphy, both involved in the semi-finals here, are trying to become the first player to win this tournament twice.
Ricky Walden, one.
Played it pretty well because you knew the blue was covering the left red and the brown, obviously, the others. And say that, there might be the tiniest of gaps between brown and blue. Well, that's not much of a gap, is it? Colin Humphreys having a look through there. Obviously, if you get that wrong, you plough into the brown and blue before you even get anywhere near the reds. Seen it before and done it before.
For me, this match has got a very similar feel to our first semi-final at the World Grand Prix a couple of weeks back. That was on the Saturday afternoon, Stuart Bingham against Joe Perry. Hard to pick a winner in that one, it was, and it went really close, and I think this one will also.
He's going for the gap. Strange old shot to play, wasn't it, with the red dangerously available just above the black. I can't imagine what he was thinking would happen there. Maybe cover it, but it was a very awkward shot to play.
One.
That red on the left of the table is quite a handy one, with the black available to the opposite corner. That's the one that Ricky had no trouble playing on. There's also the one below the pink, which frees the pink.
Four.
A reasonable chance, actually.
Five.
Well, he's been the heaviest scorer of the tournament so far, clocked up four centuries. Now, when you consider he's only played three matches, and those three matches are only the best of sevens...
11.
That's pretty good going. So he's won 12 frames in the tournament, a third of them via a century.
12.
And he was a notable omission in Clendidno, wasn't he? Fairly local player to that 19. Venue as well. He would have liked to have been up there. But the reason notable is because it was for the top 32 players. Money earners on the actual season. For a 16th player to be in the 16, but not in that, was quite unusual. A bit of an anomaly, really.
20.
And it kind of underlines that his form early season wasn't very good at all. He looks a different player now. Class always comes through in the end.
27. 28.
I sat in on Ricky Walden's press conference yesterday after his victory over Ali Carter, and he was saying he spent most of the season tinkering away, trying to change his game, trying to eke out an extra 5% or whatever that might be to
34.
improve, and he's come to the realisation that basically he needed to go back to what
35.
He does best, play naturally. And since the penny dropped, he's been a different player.
But it's human nature to tinker with something that isn't working properly at any given time.
30.
Even my playing days, which he was struggling, which towards the end of my career, came quite a lot of the time, actually. But if things weren't going very well, you'd always try and turn to someone. Nip
41.
Up to see Frank Callan, usually, up in Preston or in Blackpool. Drive up there for a couple of hours coaching, and he'd usually get your game in some kind of shape again very quickly. Dear old Frank passed away not that long ago, to his 90s.
42.
Bit of a legend of the game, but he was always there for players back then.
when we were in Llandudno. Ricky Walden and family were taking a vacation in New York City.
49.
He said he came back feeling refreshed and raring to go.
50.
And that's shown in the quality of his performances here so far.
Yeah, I should think he probably couldn't bear to be missing out on the tournament on his doorstep. Well, he's clearly not happy with that. He may still be on the red, actually. All I can think of is he played on the one below the black that's available. Because usually it will take the pace out of the ball to get a kick. Well, with a touch of left-hand side, he might be able to get through to this still. Doesn't like it. Very good, that very good shot. The harder you hit those, the more difficult it is to use a little bit of side and turn the angle around. Keeble's gone a little too far though. Now the break is becoming a struggle and he's not over the line.
Yes, the lead is 58 points, 67 still on the table. So Walden needs another colour and one more red. But where's that colour coming from and where's the red coming from?
Yes, because the problem here is if he cuts the brown, then the cue ball's heading towards the blue.
Ricky Walden, 57.
Purposely putting the blue close to the side cushion, very much in Walden's favour here. Holding all the aces. Would like to see another colour or two run awkwardly, though. And indeed, as many reds as possible.
The first semblance of a mistake from Walden. He just grazed the red on the way through, which did him no favours, actually. Pushing the blue out, I would have thought, there slightly.
Barry Hawkins, 1.
Thought he'd go up the table, to be honest. I thought he'd just play the get the blue into the middle of the table and get the cue ball down onto the bulk cushion.
So the equation is now Hawkins 57 behind, 59 on. Not a lot of leeway if he gets the chance. From there, if he did get the opportunity to clear up, he would have to pot three reds with three blacks, one red with a pink, and then all the colours to win by a single point.
Very good shot, he played that. It really is. So, last couple of shots that Ricky has played have not been his best. He's not missed a pot that he's gone for, but as it stands, Hawkins has forced this chance. A very good safety shot, the one before.
What? And I'll tell you what, right now, Walden is thankful that he had the presence of mind to put the blue close to the side cushion when he played that safety shot. That could be the saviour.
Well, he can afford to take the pink once, as Phil pointed out. He wants to get the black onto its spot here. As Phil also said, that blue is what it's all about, although I wouldn't bet too strongly against Barry Hawkins getting behind that, knocking it down the rail. It's off the cushion. The only relatively safe ball.
Nine.
And Hawkins is left-handed, which helps.
Sixteen.
Just a double check of the score. He wants to play on the pink here, which he can. I'm just looking at putting the black onto the yellow. The yellow a bit closer to the pocket makes it easier to get up there from a red-black. That'll do him. Well, he's just shaping up to play his next shot from.
Thirty-one. 33.
Well, it's been a fine start from both players. And that tells you that neither player's missed one pot they've gone for yet. I know it's early in the match, but they've both made a fine start.
36.
Just overscrewed there. Hit it almost too well. This could work one of two ways. The pot's more difficult, but he certainly can swing the cue ball around towards the blue. Not surprised he missed it thick, because he's got a bit of extra weight on the cue there. And the extension he put on there. And often that just means you just push it onto the object ball and hit them thick. Second prize is, though, this looks to be a snooker, certainly not the potting angle available. Now, I don't know if he even thought about going for a pot there, but the scenario is the worst it could be. Barry looking to see if he can get on the blue this time.
Where's the cue ball?
Foul.
In the pocket, that's the answer. And it means Hawkins now needs a snooker.
Yeah, the in-off was always on there. I think he knew that. May have had to hit it harder to force the cue ball wider. Stop that happening. And now, Alden has virtually won the frame without having to pop frame ball.
He definitely has now. Made a really good start to this frame with a super 57 break, and I think on balance probably deserves to win it.
Certainly no attempted pop there.
Yes, good start to the match, not for Barry Hawkins, but Ricky Walden will be both delighted and a little relieved. He leads Barry Hawkins in this race to six by 1-0.
Thank you. Frame two. Ricky Walden to break.
Welcome back, everyone. At Event City, we've just seen an eventful first frame. Walden breaking off, looking to double his advantage. Not the most penetrating break, that.
No, it's another one because occasionally it goes one of two ways. You give a chance away or be the best way to actually get in yourself when you break off like that. Force your opponent to play one. That was not very close to the pocket. Doesn't look like he's done an awful lot of damage. That was hit much too full. Say he wasn't doing damage, but he'd have to bury that red along the cushion if he'd have missed the double.
Eight.
An easy one, this. It's going to stun it and get the cue ball off the cushion back towards the middle of the table for the black. Oh, he stroked it beautifully. Didn't really have the angle to go into the bunch.
16.
I was just actually noting his success is still 100%, but I thought he'd miss one soon. Thought I'd just mention it. It's 24 out of 24 now. Can't last forever, of course. I don't think anyone's ever won a match with 100% pot success. But for now, Walden is on that mark.
24.
Well, I think Ronnie O'Sullivan came close when he whitewashed Ricky with an inspirational performance, 6-0 in the Masters a few years back. Walden didn't play badly in that match at all.
I don't think you got a chance to play badly, have you, when you're sitting down watching? Now, I do remember that. He hardly missed a ball. Ricky could just sit and, I guess, admire. Might not have been thinking that at the time.
Ricky Walden, 24.
Waldron is forcing a few Hawkins errors here. I mean, it's always a possibility hitting that red on the way back up. Could have been worse though.
These two have had some epic battles in the past on big stages. Career head-to-head, 5-5 in terms of wins. So hard to forecast what's going to happen.
Well,
I think one thing we can predict from the way it started, both players are really up for this. And for me, that was Hawkins' best contribution so far. Lovely shot.
Six. Seven.
Well, he's looking at the possibility of going into them. I think the red directly above the black is causing him a slight problem. Didn't have to play it. Well,
14.
Right beyond one to the right middle here. It didn't look very promising when he first played the shot, to say. Get through to that one. Now the balls are set up perfectly.
Twenty-three.
Don't be surprised, folks, by the way, if we see a barrage of breaks today.
30.
In the groove, these two build them for fun.
31.
When Hawkins beat Walden 17-14 in the semi-finals of the World Championship in 2013, they combined for five centuries in that one match alone.
Yes, and of course, I remember that match very clearly because Ricky was bossing for the first 2 days. He was in front, and it appeared that he was just going to go on, I thought, and just close out the match. But on the last day, everything changed, and he didn't play well at all, and Harry stepped up his game.
36. Walden led 12-8 in that match.
46.
It's a four-session match, and I'm pretty
47.
Sure that the only session that Barry actually won was the last, which is kind of strange, isn't it? But he won it so heavily. This has been a beautiful break, though. There is no obvious reason why this frame is not going to Barry Hawkins.
62.
Just one more red after this. That's all he needs. He's wondering which way to play on it. Play the top spin, it takes him a little bit further away from the next red. Little soft screw. That was a safe option, I think.
Seventy-one.
Good response, isn't it?
Excellent. The match is of a very high standard, which again doesn't surprise either of us, really.
78. 79.
Yes, it's a continuation from yesterday because both of these two played very well, I thought, to negotiate the quarterfinals.
86. 87.
Closing in on a century. And here's another indication of how evenly matched they are. If you think about all the matches, all the frames 96. They've played on the tour over the years.
94.
Walden has made 206. Centuries in professional competition. This would be Barry Hawkins's 202nd.
97.
Table's playing beautifully as well today. I know it's sometimes who's playing on it that makes that distinction, but it just appears to be running very smoothly.
101.
And it's always great to see a century break. Never get too blasé about them because
106.
It's a very skillful thing to make a century break at snooker.
112.
This has been a flawless century.
Very good. It is one frame each in a match that's living up to its billing. It's been a glittering start to this semi-final of the Ladbrokes Players' Championship. Barry Hawkins delighted with the way he replied to Ricky Walden's success in the opening frame.
Wanted that put up on the screen because we're into frame three now, and that's quite something, isn't it? He's not missed a ball that he's gone for, Ricky Walden, but he's still only one all in the match. Incidentally, Phil, that Ronnie O'Sullivan had 97% pot success in the match against Ricky in the Masters. Someone's just sent me a tweet with that information. 154 pots out of 159 played. I mean, it sounds good, doesn't it? And he was on the wrong end of it.
Reds are spread. Blue and black nicely available. And there's a path through.
What?
It's very unlucky for two reasons. Not only because he isn't on a colour, but because he's pushed a red over the pocket, then it puts pressure on his next safety shot.
Walden, one.
A line of three reds to hide behind, so that made the shot a little bit easier than otherwise. And it's a very good cue ball.
Yes, you're right. It wasn't actually so bad, was it? The red over the pocket with that sort of little protective shield of reds. But now what's going to happen? Because Barry's in lots of trouble. He'd like to just run into that red over the pocket. Table time 50-50. Everything just about level. The 1 point lead for Ricky Walden in the match that, now, let's be honest, it would be a very big surprise if this didn't go quite deep this match. Can't see a 6-1, 6-2 runaway. Players are just playing too well and they're too equally matched up. You never know, but it doesn't appear that way. I just wonder whether Ricky will, he's looked at the red he's very close to, but he plays off the three reds in the little bunch in the middle of the table. He could just slip in on something else. Having said that, he's going for that one. Guess there was value there, but he has officially.
Foul, Ricky Walden, 4.
Well,
ground ball. Ricky Walden, one. Three. Four. Eleven. Twelve. Twelve, Ricky Walden. Twelve. 4. Thank you. 1, Barry Hawkins. 7, Ricky Walden. Six. Seven. Fourteen. Fifteen. 20. 21. 28. 29.
Yeah. 36. 37. 41. 42. 47. 48. 55.
56. Ricky Walden, 63 on the three. Thank you. Frame four, Ricky Walden to break. 8. Nine. Sixteen. Seventeen. Yeah. 24. 25. 32. 33. 40. 41. 48. 49. 56. 57. 64. 65. 72. 73. Ricky Walden, 73. Barry Hawkins, one. Frame conceded. Frame Ricky Walden. Nine. Fifteen. Sixteen. Thank you. 21. Barry Hawkins, 22. Four. Five. Twelve. Thirteen. Twenty. Twenty-one. Twenty-eight. 29 36. 37. 43. 44. 49. Sixty-four. 65. Seventy-two. 73. 77. 79. 82. 86. 91. 97. 143. frame 6. Ricky Walden to break. Barry Hawkins, 1. One. Barry Hawkins, 1. Five. Ricky Walden, 5. One. Barry Hawkins, one. Foul, the miss. Barry Hawkins, four. One. Eight. Nine. Sixteen. 17. Barry Hawkins, 24. Ricky Walden, 1. Eight. Nine. Fifteen. 16. 19. 20. 27. Twenty-eight, Barry Hawkins. 8. Ricky Walden, 8. 4. Barry Hawkins, 4. Frame conceded. Frame Barry Hawkins. Thank you. Frame 7, Barry Hawkins to break. Touching ball. Foul and a miss. Barry Hawkins, 4. Yeah, just check that, please, Ben. Biffed. Foul and a miss. Barry Hawkins, 4. OK. You must hit her at this time or you'll lose the frame, OK? 5. Twelve. 13. Twenty-one. 27. 28. 33. 34.39. Barry Hawkins, 39. Three. 4. Nine. 10. Fifteen. Sixteen. Twenty-three. 24. 30. 31. 38. 39. 46. 47. 54. Sixty-two. 65, 69, 74. 80. 87 in the frame. Ricky Walden. Thank you, frame 8. Ricky Walden to break. Foul, miss. Ricky Walden, full. Eight. Nine. Sixteen. Seventeen. 22. 22. Ricky Walden, 22. 4. No. 10. Barry Hawkins, 10. One. Ricky Walden, one. Eight. Nine. Sixteen. Seventeen. Twenty-four. 25. 32. 33. 40. 41. 48. 49. 56. Barry Hawkins, 56. One, and the third, Barry Hawkins. Thank you. Frame 9. Barry Hawkins to break. One. Three. Four. Ricky Walton, four. Eight. Nine. Sixteen. Seventeen. Twenty-four. 32. Thirty-nine. 39. One. Ten. Eleven. Eighteen. Nineteen. Thirty-nine. Forty-two. 44. 47. 51. 51. Barry Hawkins, 5. Game in the match, 50 Walden. Congratulations, Barry.